Good wishes to all of you. Social Science, The Earth, Our Habitat, Textbook in Geography for Class 6th, 6th Chapter, Major Landforms of the Earth, Audio Book. Take a look at Figure 6.1, Landforms. Mountain, plateau, lake, tributary, river, distributary, delta, mouth of river, peninsula, sea, plain, basin, mountain range, hill, straight island. Do you know a hill is a land surface that rises higher than the surrounding area? Generally, a steep hill with an elevation of more than 600 meters is termed as a mountain. Name some mountains with a height of more than 8000 meters. You must have seen some of the landforms features as shown in the figure 6.1 below. You will notice that the surface of the earth is not the same everywhere. The earth has an infinity variety of landforms. Some parts of the lithosphere may be rugged and some flat. These landforms are the result of two processes. You will be amazed to know that the ground you are standing on is slowly moving. Within the earth, a continuous movement is taking place. The first, or the internal process, leads to the upliftment and sinking of the earth's surface at several places. Take a look at figure 6.2, fold mountains, Himalayas. A fold mountain crust. Let's do making of a mountain. 1. All you require is a pile of paper. 2. Put the papers on your table. 3. Push the papers from both sides by your hand. 4. The sheet will be folded and rise into a peak. 5. You have made a mountain. In the same process, our Himalayas and the Alps were formed. The second, or the external process, is the continuous wearing down and rebuilding of the land surface. The wearing away of the earth's surface is called erosion. The surface is being lowered by the process of erosion and rebuilt by the process of deposition. These two processes are carried out by running water, ice and wind. Broadly, we can group different landforms depending on elevation and slope as mountains, plateaus and plains. Mountains. A mountain is any natural elevation of the earth's surface. The mountains may have a small summit and a broad base. It is considerably higher than the surrounding area. Some mountains are even higher than the clouds. As you go higher, the climate becomes colder. In some mountains, there are permanently frozen rivers of ice. They are called glaciers. There are some mountains you cannot see as they are under the sea. Because of harsh climate, less people live in the mountain areas. Since the slopes are steep, less land is available for farming. Take a look at figure 6.3, a block mountain. Horst Gabern. Do you know Mauna Kea, Hawaii in the Pacific Ocean, is an undersea mountain? It is higher than Mount Everest, being 10,205 meters high. Mountains may be arranged in a line known as range. Many mountain systems consist of a series of parallel ranges extending over hundreds of kilometers. The Himalayas, the Alps and the Andes are mountain ranges of Asia, Europe and South America respectively. Figure 5.1. Mountains vary in their heights and shape. There are three types of mountains: fold mountains, block mountains and the volcanic mountains. The Himalayan mountains and the Alps are young fold mountains with rugged relief and high conical peaks. The Aravalli range in India is one of the oldest fold mountain systems in the world. The range has considerably worn down due to the process of erosion. The Appalachians in North America and the Ural Mountains in Russia, figure 5.1, have rounded features and low elevation. They are very old fold mountains. Block mountains are created when large areas are broken and displaced vertically The uplifted blocks are termed as horsts and the lower blocks are called garben. The Rhine Valley and the Vosges Mountain in Europe are examples of such mountain systems. Locate them on the world map in the atlas and find out some more examples of this type of landforms. Volcanic mountains are formed due to volcanic activity. Mount Kilimanjaro in Africa and Mount Fujiyama in Japan are examples of such mountains. Mountains are very useful. The mountains are a storehouse of water. Many rivers have their source in the glaciers in the mountains. Reservoirs are made and the water is harnessed for the use of people. Water from the mountain is also used for irrigation and generation of hydroelectricity. The river valleys and terraces are ideal for cultivation of crops. Mountains have a rich variety of flora and fauna. The forests provide fuel, fodder, shelter and other products like gum, resins, etc. Mountains provide an idyllic site for tourists. They visit the mountains for their scenic beauty. Several sports like paragliding, hang gliding, river rafting and skiing are popular in the mountains. Can you name some places in the Himalayas associated with these sports? Take a look at figure 6.4, a volcanic mountain. Huge cloud of steam. Magma builds up here under enormous pressure. Molten rocks flowing down the side is called lava. Lava bombs. The volcanic cone is composed of layers of ash and lava. Huge cloud of steam, volcanic ash and gas. Can you name this sport? Take a look at figure 6.5. Plateau. Plateaus. A plateau is in A plateau is an elevated flatland. It is a flat-topped tableland standing above the surrounding area. A plateau may have one or more sides with steep slopes. The height of plateaus often varies from few hundred meters to several thousand meters. Plateaus like mountains may be young or old. The Deccan Plateau in India is one of the oldest plateaus. The East African Plateau in Kenya, Tanzania and Uganda and the Western Plateau of Australia are other examples. The Tibet Plateau figure 5.1, page 31 is the highest plateau in the world with a height of 4000 to 6000 meters above the mean sea level. Plateaus are very useful because they are rich in mineral deposits. As a result, many of the mining areas in the world are located in the plateau areas. The African Plateau is famous for gold and diamond mining. In India, huge reservoirs of iron, coal and manganese are found in the Chota Nagpur Plateau. Take a look at figure 6.6, plains. In the plateaus areas, there may be several waterfalls as the river falls from the great high. In India, the Hundro Falls in the Chota Nagpur Plateau on the river Subarnarekha and the Jog Falls in Karnataka are examples of such waterfalls. The lava plateaus are rich in black soil that are fertile and good for cultivation. Many plateaus have scenic spots and are of great attraction to tourists. Plains. Plains are large stretches of flat land. They are generally not more than 200 meters above mean sea level. Some plains are extremely level. Others may be slightly rolling and undulating. Most of the plains are formed by rivers and their tributaries. The rivers flow down the slopes of mountains and erode them. They carry forward the eroded material. Then they deposit their load consisting of stones, sand and silt along their courses and in their valleys. It is from these deposits that plains are formed. Generally, plains are very fertile. Construction of transport network is easy. Thus, these plains are very thickly populated regions of the world. Some of the largest plains made by the rivers are found in Asia and North America. For example, in Asia, these plains are formed by the Ganga and the Brahmaputra in India and the Yangtze in China. Plains are the most useful areas for human habitation. There is great concentration of people as more flat land is available for building houses as well as for cultivation because of fertile soils. The land is highly productive for cultivation. In India, too, the Indo-Gangetic plains are the most densely populated regions of the country. Take a look at figure 6.7, Rope Bridge, Arunachal Pradesh. Take a look at figure 6.8, a polluted river. Do you know, Swachh Bharat Mission healthy mind lives in healthy body, and for a healthy body, clean environment, particularly clean water, air and hygienic surrounding are prerequisites. Swachh Bharat Mission, a Government of India program, aims to achieve all these for people. Landforms and the people. Humans have been living on different kinds of landforms in different ways. Life is difficult in mountainous areas. Plains provide much better conditions. It is easy to grow crops, build a house or a road in a plain than a mountain. Can you point out some differences in the ways people live on different kinds of landforms? Sometimes natural calamities such as earthquakes, volcanic eruption, storms and floods cause widespread destruction. Huge loss of life and property takes place. By creative awareness about such incidents, we may lower the risk. You may find out from your own surroundings in how many ways we use the land and water. Quite often we use the land in a wasteful manner. For example, constructing houses on a fertile land. Similarly, we throw garbage on land or in water, making them dirty. We should avoid using such important gifts of nature in a careless manner. The available land is not only for our use. It is our duty to leave the earth a better place for future generations as well. Look carefully at photographs. Notes 1 to 10. Write one sentence about each of the photographs. Name the landform feature shown in the photograph notes 1, 2 and 7. What appears to be the main use of this land? Photograph 9. Photograph number 9. What activities do you see in the photograph numbers 3, 6, 8 and 9? What type of houses do you see in photograph numbers 4 and 5? Name the water sports games shown in photograph numbers 3 and 8. Name two means of transport shown in photographs numbers 1 and 10. Exercises 1. Answer the following questions briefly. A. What are the major landforms? B. What is the difference between a mountain and a plateau? C. What are the different types of mountains? D. How are mountains useful to man? E. How are plains formed? F. Why are the river plains thickly populated? G. Why are mountains thinly populated? Take the correct answers. A. The mountains differ from the hills in terms of B. Glaciers are found in C. The Deccan Plateau is located in D. The river Yangtze flows in E. An important mountain range of Europe is fill in the blanks. A dash is an unbroken flat or a low-level land. The Himalayas and the Alps are examples of dash types of mountains. Dash areas are rich in mineral deposits. The dash is a line of mountain. The dash areas are most productive for farming. Things to do. What kind of landforms are found in your state? Based on the readings of this chapter, say how they are of use to the people. Map skills. On an outline map of the world, marks the following: mountain ranges, Himalayas, Rockies, and Andes. Plateau, Tibet. Thank you.